Good morning, children. I am Ms. Julian Peter, class teacher of Standard 2A. Today, we are going to learn English literature. And the first chapter is The Magic Porridge Pot. So everyone, take out your book. Now, I will explain to you the chapter. Now, in this chapter, once there was a little girl named Poppy. She lived with her mother in a cottage near the forest. One morning, while she was walking down the forest, she met an old lady. This old lady was carrying four heavy bags. Children, you can see the picture here and you will better understand. See the picture? Okay. She was returning from the market, so Poppy helped her carry the heavy bags. The old lady was happy and gave her a reward. And what was the reward? A little porridge pot. This pot was not an ordinary pot, but a special one. The old lady showed Poppy how the pot worked. She told her when she will say cook, little pot cook, the pot will give her delicious, hot, creamy porridge. And once she has eaten enough, instruct the pot to stop cooking by saying, stop, little pot, stop, or it will carry on cooking. Poppy thanked the old lady and rushed to her home to show the pot to her mother. A few days later, Poppy went to visit her grandmother. When she was not at home, her mother began to feel hungry. So she took out the pot from the shelf and kept it on the table. Cook, little pot, cook, she said, and the pot cooked delicious, hot, creamy porridge. She ate the porridge and soon went off to sleep. She forgot to tell the pot to stop cooking. So the pot cooked and cooked until there was porridge everywhere. The porridge poured out of the pot onto the floor, through the rooms, down the stairs, out of the door, into the lanes, and all over the town. Children, you will better understand when you see the picture in your book. Just see and you will understand how the porridge is all over the town. Then, now what happens? When Poppy came back, she was surprised to see this and shouted, stop, little pot, stop. At last, the little pot stopped. Since there was porridge all over the town, everyone had to eat it for breakfast, lunch, tea, and dinner. Now, did you understand this chapter, children? So, next what we will do, we are going to mark the spellings so that you can learn the spellings by heart. Children, here are some spellings. You have to mark it. Underline the words. First one is cottage, edge, sunny, walking, carrying, heavy, market, little, porridge, special, showed, worked, delicious, creamy. Now turn the page. Eaten, enough, cooking, thanked, clutching, excitedly, visiting, grandma, hungry, shelf, bowlful, rocking, forgotten, everywhere, poured, floor, through, stairs, lanes, shouted, stopped, breakfast, lunch, tea, dinner. Now, below here you will see at the bottom of your book some word meanings are there. So you have to learn these word meanings by heart, like cottage, woods, porridge, delicious, clutching, as far as her legs would carry her, large bowlful, poured, lanes. Next, we move on to the question answers. Now, few question answers you will see here. I have written for you the question answers. Just I am going to read the question answers. You write these question answers in your notebook. The first question is, where did Poppy live? Poppy lived with her mother in a cottage at the edge of the woods. Number two, why did Poppy run home? Poppy ran home to show the magic pot to her mother. Number three, why did Poppy go to the other side of the woods? Poppy went to the other side of the woods to visit her grandma. Number four, why did Poppy's mother put the porridge pot on the table? Answer, Poppy's mother put the porridge pot on the table because she began to feel hungry. Number five, where did Poppy's mother fall asleep? Answer, Poppy's mother fell asleep in her rocking chair. Okay, children? Now, reference to the context, I have written the answers here, but the questions you will see in your book. The questions are in the book. You will write the questions from the book and answers are here written in the copy. Reference to the context, number A, answer 2A. Who was walking in the woods? Answer is, Poppy was walking in the woods. Number B, what time of the day was it? It was a sunny morning. Number C, how did the girl help the old lady? Answer, the girl helped the old lady by carrying her heavy bags. Now, moving on to question number 3. Number A, what could the pot do? The pot could cook delicious, hot, creamy porridge. Next one, number B, 3B. Who gave Poppy the pot? The old lady gave Poppy the pot. Number C, which word shows us how Poppy was feeling? The word excitedly shows us how Poppy was feeling. Now next, read, reflect and write. Question number 4, how did the town get full of porridge? Answer, the town got full of porridge because Poppy's mother forgot to tell the pot to stop cooking. Question number 5. How do you think Poppy's mother felt when she woke up? Answer, Poppy's mother felt very bad when she woke up. Question number 6. What did everyone do to see that the porridge was not wasted? Answer, everyone had to eat it for breakfast, lunch, tea and dinner. Question number 7. Why is it wrong to waste food? It is wrong to waste food because food is a gift of God. Now question number 8. Poppy helped the old lady. What are some things we can do to help older people? We can help them to cross the road. We can offer our seats to them while traveling. These are the make sentences which you have to make on your own. The words are market, delicious, caring, excitedly. Dear parents, I request you to please help and guide your child to complete the work in his notebook. Children, this is the timetable of standard 2A. Please note, and these are the copies required for the following subjects. You have to please make sure that the books and copies are neatly covered. Thank you.